Mr. Magar, Magarpatta city has been a success, but there have been challenges, and one of the biggest challenges was in the first 2-3 years after you launched, when the property market went into a crisis. How did you handle that period?
Yeah, 2001-2003 was not a good time. The market was extremely low, people were not buying. That is the time we really went into a very aggressive mode of marketing. We went across cities, we went to all the urban areas, we went to the Middle East, where we thought that, you know, investment buying can come in. And we also, by that time even IT started. So IT in 2001, we started the building. 2003, I think we gave possession, and because of the IT buildings coming up, there was people who wanted jobs there, or people who wanted to buy on rent, or people who wanted to give on rent, that market opened up. So it was a tough time. We kept our overheads in control. We kept our spends in control. We, you know, went on that conventional system that in any building you start, you first target 30% sale. So your RC is taken care of. Once your RC is taken care of, people get the confidence, and then you move further. So we were very aggressive for the first 30% to get people in to start and come. So we worked on with banks, we worked with financial institutions to give good packages to people. We worked on giving good service to the customer. We came in with a lot of, you know, introduce the customer scheme, or create your own neighborhood scheme type of where, you know, people would ask their neighbors or anyone whether they want to come, or their colleagues in the office to come and buy here. So we incentivize them slightly on that, so that, you know, that whole process started with that.
Was that the time when you realized that you need to find ways of cutting overheads? Like, one thing omnipresent in the entire township is the focus on solar energy. Was that phase a testing ground where you said, let's find ways to keep overheads low?
No, that was one. See, like, not only solar, we have that overhead water tank. So it's pumping of water only at one time, and then all the water tanks are filled by gravity, because that was an expensive thing which would happen. Secondly was solar. Solar we started thinking a little bit later, when we were maintaining the township, the power bills were very high. So how do you curtail the power bills? To use solar. So we have 6 megawatt, more than 5 megawatt is already installed, and we have another 1.5 megawatt which is in process. But it all started how to save time and how to bring in cost and how to bring in sustainability. Sustainability was the biggest factor which came with all these measures.
So just in terms of numbers, these initiatives in terms of overheads coming down, these measures that you took, how much has that helped in your bottom line or your cost savings?
See, the solar, the power bills of the common areas and all the other facilities which requires common power has come down to 20%. It's about 1 crore of savings of every month, which came in by way of using the solar power.
Is that also one of the reasons why residents over here don't have a maintenance fee that they have to pay after they buy the apartment?
We have taken a maintenance fee at the beginning. And then we manage everything here. We manage distribution of water, then distribution of power. We manage the entire facilities here. And the commercial area cross-subsidizes something, but we have a surplus generated because of these savings. And then that's why people don't have to pay monthly basis or ongoing basis.
Have there been any mistakes that if you were to go back in time, you would like to change about your journey from 1999 till today on Magarpatta city?
Magarpatta city, I don't think we have made any mistakes like what I can feel, what we can regret about. Mm-hmm. Because ultimately, you know, this is like first love, which you always cherish. So, and this was done with a lot of passion because these are our roots. So in Magarpatta, we have not made many mistakes, but in Nanded city, we did make a mistake at the time of launching. That time RERA was not there. So we said we'll take pre-booking launching before the plans got approved. And I don't know what happened. And everyone thought that there's not going to be any house thereafter. And we had 7,000 bookings. In 4 days, the rate went up from 2,500 to 4,000 rupees. And we were also thinking like it is like the stock market windfall which has come. And the permissions took 2 years after that. We had to return the 7,000 people with the checks or the money which we had taken with them. And the people whose checks were cashed really gave us a tough time. Because they said, why you are returning the money? And we told them it's going to take time. Then why did you book if you had? But that was a mistake. I don't think we'll repeat that mistake again. Now RERA doesn't allow you to repeat it. But we'll not repeat it again. That was a big learning for us.
There are several planners and developers who are looking to emulate your sort of model. Are there some developers whose models you would like to implement? Some parts of developers that you would like to encourage?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the buildings which Niranjan Hiranandani makes are beautiful. You know, everyone would want to make them. The marketing which Lodas do is something different. The sheer magnitude of DLF is something different. But there are many things you want to do, but there are very few things which you can do. So it's a big, you know, it's a dichotomy between what you want to do and what you can do. So we try and do what we can do and not what we want to do, but the perception, you know, is always there that why can't we do it this way? But we do it within the framework of what we are.
Is there something in particular you like about Godrej and Oberoi that you would like to take inspiration for regarding?
Godrej has a big brand value, which really helps them a lot. That is what I feel. Oberoi again is classy. But we deal for a segment which is probably middle class or, you know, upward mobile middle class. That is what we call people who are aspiring to become upper middle class from middle class. Mm-hmm. Where this fanciness, this classicness, all has their own restrictions. So it's, you know, it's good to see others and learn from them and do your own way.
Looking at your journey, two things stand out. One is you're focused on land pooling. Second is planned development. Why do you think land pooling has not taken off in India?
It's very personalized. You have to spend a lot of time. You have to handle a lot of people. The three townships together, we have more than 3,500 farmer families. So you have to have a lot of emotional connect with them. For us, it was possible because I belong to the same community. I've been born and brought up in Magarpatta. So, you know, that you can converse with them. That is what is required. So probably I feel that probably you need to be a farmer, not a farmer for investment, but an original farmer to do the land pooling, to keep them together. Require a lot of patience to handle them. They are all weird demands. You have to be tough at sometimes. You have to, you know, pat at sometimes. You have to box at sometimes. There are so many things which keep on happening. It's not a very easy thing to do. Mm-hmm. That's why probably it has not taken up. And you require it to be extremely transparent, and you require to be extremely clear on your concepts. Because people, everything, then they start. Once they start doubting, then they'll doubt everything.
In most of the videos I see about you, by some by your fans on YouTube, there is one figure who looms large, Sharad Pawar. Would this project have been the way it is with him? How important has he been in this project?
No, he was the person who believed that we could do it. At that point in 1994, when he was the chief minister and when we went to him first, he said that I'm not going to give any, you don't ask for any government exemptions. You do the regular process and do it. But he believed that farmers could come together and do it. That was the biggest thing as a confidence booster to all of us, because that belief, when nobody believed, he believed. So, it, and he has always been a, you know, helping hand to guide. And in fact, in 97, he asked me to go to San Jose with the Chamber of Commerce delegation. You'll not believe it, I didn't have a passport also that time. I had to get a passport, get a US visa, went with the chamber for a US trip, just to learn what IT was. So he said that this is going to be the sunrise industry because Y2K is coming. To understand Y2K, it took me some time, because what was Y2K? So in 2000, you know, the all computer configuration, a lot of business is going to come to India. That itself gave us the whole idea of going to San Jose, and after coming from San Jose, why don't we do a knowledge park here, do an IT park here, you know, knowledge-based industry, because Pune has the thing. So his vision and his encouragement, I think, helped a lot.